Welcome back, everyone. Many of us are familiar with linear growth. What we put in, we get proportionally out. While some areas of our lives are following this pattern, some are follow another, namely the exponential pattern. We will look at the mental model of compounding to better understand this. This we will do with the help of two legendary investors, Warren Buffett and Charlie Munger. Both are naturally familiar with compounding and are using it in many areas of life. Compounding is mainly associated with the area of finance. To explain this concept now, we will say inside this area. Compounding is when an investment grows, not just based on the initial amount we put in, but also on the interest or returns it earns over time. This then creates exponential growth. Let's take an example and visualize, looking at simple interest and compound interest. Both start with 1000 currency, whatever this currency is, initial investment, with a 10% interest rate. Simple interest affects only the initial investment. The 10% gets applied to our initial investment every year. Compound interest, on the other side, is based on the initial investment plus the accumulated interest or returns of our investment. So the 10% get not only applied to the initial investment, but also to the earnings we had from the periods before. After 10 years, you can already see a difference. At 30 years, even more. Plotting this as a graph, we can see that simple interest has a linear function, while compounding is exponential. One crucial ingredient for compounding is time. A general advice is found in the following Chinese proverb. The best time to plant a tree was 20 years ago. The second best time is today. The moment we want something to compound, we better start early because time is our friend. As we saw in the previous example, the longer our time horizon or time frame is, the better compounding plays out. Consistency is the next crucial ingredient for compounding. The first rule of compounding is to never interrupt it unnecessarily, by Charlie Munger. In regard to the previous example, when we take our money out at any time, it will stop compounding. When we do everything only once, it will not compound. It will not even start to compounding. When we just go to the gym one time and then stop at all, it will not compound. When we train the piano for 1 hour and then stopping at all, it will not compound. So what we need is consistency and time. Somehow for me, it was like that I was a long time thinking in this linear growth mindset, until I realized that many areas or domains of our lives are following the exponential pattern and not the linear pattern. In the example before, with simple interest, we saw how linear growth looks like. It is basically that input and output are matched, they are proportional to each other. Now, as an example, we can take the hourly worker, someone who gets paid per hour. When this person now works 5 hours and gets 20 currency, like let's say dollar. So 5 hours and $20, that means he gets, or she gets $100 per day. When we now double the amount worked, so from 5 to 10, we also double automatically the payment. So this means that they are proportional. Input and output are matched. We look now at compounding, mainly from the financial view. The beauty of mental models in general, and specifically from compounding, is that we can find them in many areas. Areas which include compounding are habits, relationships, finance, health, knowledge, learning, and many, many more. In the rest of the video, we will look at some areas where compounding can be applied. Compounding, or exponential growth, cannot just work for us, but also against us. You only get one mind and one body, and it's got to last a lifetime. Now, it's very easy to let them ride for many years, but if you don't take care of that mind and that body, they will be a wreck 40 years later. It's what you do right now, today, that determines how your mind and body will operate 10, 20, and 30 years from now, by Warren Buffett. When we don't take care many years of our body and mind, it will look pretty worse in the future to come. In the beginning of compounding, we don't really feel probably the effects. So when we treat our mind or body 1, 2, 3 years badly, probably we don't feel it because we are just in the beginning of the exponential growth. But when we reach a breakpoint and we cross a border and the function, so to speak, gets exponential, then things will get really difficult. Another point he makes is that we do actions or decisions today and they will ultimately, of course, influence our future. So they have future consequences. This is basically talking about the second order, third order, or nth order consequences of an action or decision we take today. About this, it's the mental model, second order thinking, I made a previous video. So when you're interested in that, feel free to check it out. Another area which compounds, and many of us are probably not so aware of, is the area of thoughts. Positive thoughts are taking care of themselves and we can just let them alone. But negative thoughts create more and more negative thoughts. I experience this by myself and it's really not so easy to break free from them. In the beginning, they are just sneaking in and we are like in the beginning of the exponential function. And they are coming slowly and they don't have so much effect, so it's actually okay. But when we don't stop them early, they grow to the exponential curve and then things get really difficult to reverse. The best way to negative compounding is to stop it in the beginning. The best way to positive compounding is a long time frame and consistency. James Clear wrote in his book Atomic Habits, in order to get better overall, we should focus on getting 1% better every day. The following picture is from his book. What we can see is that even a tiny improvement, in our case 1%, done consistently, can lead to something big. I find it incredible that we can get 37 times better in 1 year by only a 1% increase daily. Considering here a quote by Charlie Munger, to get step by step, every day, a little bit better, the consistency part, and that over a long time frame. The time aspect. Spend each day trying to be a little wiser than you were when you woke up. Discharge your duties faithfully and well. Step by step you get ahead, but not necessarily in fast spurts. But you build discipline by preparing for fast spurts. Slug it out 1 inch at a time, day by day, and at the end of the day, if you live long enough, most people get what they deserve. By Charlie Munger. One additional thing to compounding is that we often don't see immediate results. We compare now two situations. Me as a content creator and me in a monthly salary job. In a monthly salary job, I have this linear growth, or not necessarily growth, but I have just this linear line with my stable salary. As a content creator now, I earned the first 8-9 months zero. This is just how it is, because in the beginning it's just really slow. But when I go to this exponential curve, things can look really fast, really different, or actually also not. Impatience with actions. Patience with results, by Naval, Ravikant. To see compounding in action, we will look now at my YouTube journey so far. The following graph I will show you is a graph pretty simplified and only focuses on clicks. Before I told you that I don't earn any money with it, and we don't see any compounding in my money, which is clear because 000 is no, not compounding, but we can see compounding in my average views. And this we will now look at. I started in March this year. On average, I got around 80 clicks per video with a high variability. The most watched video until November got 350 views, the least 50. Averaging per day was probably 10 to 15 views. The last two videos, however, got more than 1000 views and averaging out 500 views per day. We can observe here three things. First, my input doesn't match the output, no linear growth. I put quite similar input in my worst video and best video. Second, compounding is slow in the beginning. For me, every single subscriber means a lot. It takes time and patience. And third, when you are in an area where things are compounding, don't give up. Time and consistency are again key. It is helpful to consider the mental model of compounding in our everyday lives. We have to be especially careful when compounding takes a negative turn. On the positive side, however, little improvements every day done consistently can lead to something big. Again, time and consistency. Here's the last quote to think about. Compound interest is the eighth wonder of the world. He who understands it, earns it. He who doesn't, pays it. By Albert Einstein. Thank you so much for taking the time to watch this video, and I hope you could get some value out of it. As always, I wish you a fantastic day.